But I think what's really nice about yoga is, it's like if you do, like I do kickboxing, say for an hour, and how I feel after an hour when I lie down, and then how do I feel after 1 hour of yoga when I lie down? It's a completely different feeling.
Absolutely.
And that's when you can compare what it's doing to your insides.
Because
you're
doing both, that's why you can make out the difference. Yeah. But people who just follow one regimen do not know the difference.
Yeah.
You know, and it really works. And where you say it calms you down, it changes the structure of your body. Lots of people don't realize that. But it tones you to the maximum.
Yeah.
Actually, we have a star here who's been completely upfront. So most people say, you know, it's very easy. But we heard her say that it kills you. But now that you've gotten into it, are you enjoying it? Is there a time, if you haven't done it,
I think it's a kind of addiction, you know. When you start to see the difference in your body and you start to see what that workout is doing to you and the kind of feel-good factor that it gives to you, you know. A lot of times, you know, they ask me in the beauty routine, what is the best thing? The question was, when do you find yourself looking the hottest? And, you know, I kept thinking and I said that, you know, I think it's right after a workout.
It's right after a workout.
You come back to your bathroom, yeah. You look yourself in the mirror, and I think the time where you feel that you're looking the hottest is when your face is flushing and you sweat out. And it's just such a good feeling about yourself.
Very good because you're sweating it out.
And it's a good feeling about yourself, you know. So I think
no makeup can
be no,
makeup.
No, 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 no.
So have you always been interested in fitness?
My father was in the army, you know, so I wasn't interested, but I was made to feel interested because he would kick us and tell us to, you know, go and play some sport or the other. So it was in the family always, but I would say that for me it became serious only after I had, you know, come into this profession, and it's become even more important now than ever for I think everybody, not just me. But like I said, once you start to see the differences when you get addicted to it and you want to keep at it.
You keep moving between Delhi and Bombay, and you have a child and full life.
Yeah.
So how do you manage to, you know, it's hard work to stick to the right diet and exercise. How do you manage to do that? If you can give us some tips.
I think the only tip is to always be at it. I was talking to someone and, you know, we had a debate and where they were saying that obsession is not a good thing. Probably not good, and it should be in moderation. I just feel that if you want something and you want it to the best, then you have to be obsessed to a certain point. And obsession means that you think of that thing all the time. It's something in the back of your mind that you're aware of all the time. I wouldn't say I'm obsessed, but I think constantly aware of it. So what you eat, what you do, when you sleep, whether you're having your water or you're not, it is something that is just there and it becomes natural.
Be mindful
all the time. Yeah. And I think when you have that information there, then you make your choices.
Yeah, it's a lifestyle change.
Exactly.
Okay. That's not an obsession.
Sorry, that's the point.
Yeah, I get it.
Fine, we should actually ask you whether yoga makes that possible.
It is definitely. If you want to stick to a regimen like yoga, you have to change your lifestyle because food comes into a process. Your eating, your sleeping, like she said, it's very, very important. So fitness, you know, like what you said, because it's an obsession. It's not an obsession, it's a lifestyle.
That's the wrong word probably, yeah.
Yeah, it's a lifestyle because how we eat, we need to eat, we need to sleep. Yeah. We all eat and we all love eating. So, but we don't say we all love fitness, you know. So that's what has to be put into people. And it works for everyone.
You earlier spoke about beauty, and in our cover story actually, Chitrangada says that she doesn't really follow a beauty regime and she doesn't really need facials or any products.
Yeah.
So how do you do this?
She should not say that.
No,
she
is really, really pretty, so I'm sure that.
You know,
anyway, give
us something. Yeah, you know, I mean, yeah, I'm just saying that, you know, facials and all that is something. I don't know, I think it's kind of a little superficial. Of course, you need to clean your skin. You need to get the makeup off your face. You know, you need to sleep with a clean skin, definitely, so that your pores are open and they breathe, and all of that is really important. But I think the best facial is a good one. You know, when from the inside that you really spread it out and, you know, you It's something happening to your body from the inside, which is the best thing to do.
It's basically the blood circulation. Okay,
she has all the words that I'm missing.
The blood circulation. So that's what happens. That's why the skin is glowing. In yoga, we do a lot of inverted postures, which is very, very good for a glowing skin.
I do that.
Yeah. So that's very good. Shirshasana. If you do the headstands.
I do headstands. Yeah.
Yeah. For so that works. That's brilliant. That's brilliant.
That is actually the best position.
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. So we come to your films. You said that you don't want to be. We've actually called the story out of the box because.